right line is the lifeline to a nation. And men like Will and Sonny make it move. A good hot cup of coffee is waiting up ahead, and the rhythm of the highway hums along. Jamming gears has got to be a fever, cause men become addicted to the grind. It takes a special breed to be a truck driving man, and a steady hand to pull that load behind. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on.
Something, partner, you got a big mouth.
All right, now read that last bit again.
All right. There is no job that takes more strength and stamina.
All right. Now, you know I don't use words like stamina. The guy that interviewed me just jazzed it up a little.
Jazzed it up. Well, then how about this little riff? Truckers are the toughest men in America.
Yeah, that's right.
You said that.
I said it. I mean it.
Toughest men in America.
Look, nobody ever got hurt by telling the truth. Fill me up, huh?
Right. Hey, fella.
Yeah?
Is this you?
Yeah, it's me.
Yeah, well, I'm a logger.
So?
So,
what was that all about?
He's a logger. I'd say he thinks that loggers are the toughest men in America. So probably do the stevedores, the miners, roughnecks on the oil rigs, and the steel workers. He probably got the backs up of half the working men in the United States.
Yeah, well, that's their problem.
No, it's your problem. Now, what would you do if a guy came up to you and said, "We're the toughest guys in America"?
I'm probably deck 'em.
QED.
What?
Quo erat demonstrandum.
Oh. How many guys you figure you're gonna take a shot at me?
Well, how big is your mouth?
I could have taken that logger.
Yeah, well, that's good, because I figure he's the first in a long line of loggers and guys you're gonna have to take.
We'll be taken by.
They're here now. They didn't order yet. Oh, about 20 minutes or so.
To tell you the truth, I'd like to help you drive, but you're one of the toughest men in America.
Bunny.
Did anybody ever tell you about the sanctity of the three American M's?
What?
There are three things in America that are sacrosanct. You don't criticize motherhood, marriage, or the Marines.
I never said anything about marriage or motherhood.
What about the Marines?
Well, the guy asked me if I thought that we truckers were tougher than the Marines.
And then you said, "I never met a seagoing bellhop who could make it for a week as a trucker."
Did you have to call them bellhops?
That's what we called them in the Navy, when we weren't calling them jarheads.
Yeah, you got around to that, too.
Hey, Sundance, you out there?
This is Sundance. Go ahead.
Pappy Pete, say, have you guys got a load?
Pappy Pete, we just made a drop.
You know Sneed's Ferry?
Yeah, we know it. We know it well.
If you get over there fast, you can pick up a load.
Ask him what it is, where it's going.
What do you got and where's it going?
Sorry, can't hear you. Getting interference. That ought to do it.
Yeah, you better buy your beer. Aren't you just dying to know what's over at Sneed's Ferry?
Well, we can find out in about 15 minutes.
All the rigs. This place sure got popular all of a sudden.
Look at that sign. How about that?
Let's get out of here, Pruitt.
Let's get out of here.
Yeah.
Well, you can read.
Yeah, I can read. It spells T-R-O-U-B-L-E. Let's go.
Well, now, how do you figure that?
Gut reaction. Let's
Look,
go.
It's all that funny health food you've been
all
eating.
All right.
Come on. Let's go meet my adoring public.
Speaking of adoring public...
Moose and Benji's rig.
Yeah. Now, can we go?
Now, wait a minute. Deep down, they're not such bad guys.
You weren't talking like that 6 weeks ago when they conned you out of that load in Boston.
But forgive and forget. That's my motto.
How about that time last year when they hotwired the rig and borrowed it to haul a load of hogs? It took us a week to get rid of that stink, and I'm not just talking about the hogs.
Look, they're here, right? And this is obviously some kind of a celebration for me, right? So let's just be... Bygones be bygones, okay?
Oh, kiss and make
Yeah, up. Right. Forgive and forget.
All right. Kiss.
All right. Well.
Hey, Sonny, hey. How you doing? Good to see you, man.
How are you, Sonny?
For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow.
Sing, tell me, sing.
Yeah, I don't know the words.
Yeah, nobody can deny.
Hey, Pete. Hey, Bonnie. Hey, Charlie. Hey, Moose. Benji.
How you doing, Moose?
Hey, how are you?
Hey, how are you, Sonny, huh?
Say hello to Sonny, Benji.
How you doing, Sonny? What's happening?
You really started something, huh?
I did?
Mm-hmm.
Toughest man in America.
Oh, bad, yeah.
I love that bit about the Marines. What'd you call them? Seagoing bellhops.
Oh, yeah.
That's terrific, huh, Benji?
Yeah. Of course, on the Marines, they don't agree. They think they're the toughest men in America.
Well, everybody's entitled to his own opinion.
I mean, after all, I mean, that's not just an opinion, right? I mean, it's something you could prove, right?
Well, sure I could if I had to.
That's exactly what I told him.
What?
I told him that Sonny here can prove he's tougher. I said if you put Sonny and Will on that base for 1 week... They run those gyrenes right into the ground.
Sure I could prove it, Moose, but they're just going to have to take my word for it.
Should I tell them now, Moose?
Would you be quiet, Benji?
Benji, tell them what?
Well, let me tell them, huh? Me and Benji and the guys, well, we got together, you see, and we got together this arrangement, you see.
So we came up with this plan.
Sergeant Harris? Come on over here. Guys, I want you to meet Gunnery Sergeant Harris.
He's a Marine.
No kidding.
Mr. Pruitt?
Mr. Chandler? I'm here to challenge you to put your pudgy bodies on the line.
Sergeant Harris, why don't you leave this pudgy body out of that?
We've been the toughest men in America for 200 years.
And the most modest, too.
Mr. Pruitt, you have a big mouth. But you couldn't cut it as a Marine for a week, and you know it. Or you'd come aboard and prove how tough you are.
Well, you know, guys, I got one little problem. I got to make a living. I got a business.
Oh, see, Sonny, I already took care of that. You see, I got the guys together. We got this little pool, and I raised $500. Now, that's more money than you make in a week. Now, the Marines have promised to give you free room and board, so there's no overhead. You'll probably end up making money.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, you know, we'd do it in a minute, but no gunny sergeant's got that kind of juice. I mean, that would take all kinds of brass to approve it.
The battalion commander okayed it, and regiment, and division.
You're putting me on, Gunny. I mean, for Will and I to train with the Jarheads, what, that would take a shoulder full of stars right out of Washington.
Already approved. Washington thinks the whole thing will provide some good publicity for the Marine Corps. It'll be the first time in 200 years anybody's had the chance to play Marine for a week. It'll probably never happen again. So put up or shut up.
Shut up. Shut up, shut up.
I'll be expecting you at the main gate, Camp Lejeune, at 1500. And we'll see who are the toughest men in America.
Got to.
We don't got to do anything.
A week here, it'll be like a vacation.
Devil's Island.
I don't understand what you're afraid of.
I'm not afraid of anything. I'm just realistic. There are 30,000 guys on the other side of that fence, and every one of them is waiting to see if we can hack it.
But it's only a week. You heard the deal. All we have to do is do whatever Gyrene does for a week, and we win.
What do we win?
We prove that truckers are tougher than the Marines. You saw those guys back at the diner. They're counting on us. Now, how's it going to look if we chicken out?
One of these days, I'm going to tape that mouth of yours shut permanently. I'm going to suture it.
Well, are you in or aren't you?
You'd do it without me, wouldn't you?
Sure I would. I got to.
Who's going to tuck you in at night, brush your teeth, get you to eat the right kind of food?
You're in.
Yeah. I'm in. Up to here, I'm in.
I'm Sonny Pruitt, Will Chandler.
Gunny.
Out of the truck, please. From now on, until you limp or are carried out of here, you're going to bust your butts to act like Marines. You're going to do what Marines do, and you're going to do it like Marines. Is that clear?
Part of the deal.
Well, that's no problem, Gunny. I was in the Navy, World War II, before you were born. So, for a sailor, acting like a Marine is like going on Liberty in Honolulu. It's just one big party.
I was 3 years old in World War II, but I already knew the difference between a Marine and a swab jockey.
Hey, wait a minute. Wait, where's he going?
He's driving it to the motor pool.
Hey, that's no three-speed stick shift, you know.
He's checked out on Jeeps, deuce-and-a-halves, dozers, Amtraks, and tanks. Handling your rig is kid stuff to a Marine. Carry on, Marine. Consider yourselves riflemen. 2nd Squad, 1st Platoon, B Company, 1st Battalion, 8th Marine, 2nd Marine Division. You're here for 1 week, if you can take it. We don't think you can, and we've got money on it.
How much have you got on it, personally?
$50. But no Marine is going to step one inch out of line. You'll be treated exactly the same way as every other man on this base. When you don't make it, it'll be because you can't. Not because any Marine tries to pull a fast one. Sergeant James, Mr. Macon. Sergeant James is a photographer from the Camp Lejeune Globe. Mr. Macon is with American Scene. They'll be covering your week here. If it makes you feel any better, Mr. Chandler, they'll be around to see that nobody breaks the rules. Satisfied?
Oh, fine.
Then from here on, try acting like your Marines. Let's go. Amen. Here's your turkeys.
What's that hair for? Matches.
Full haircuts.
That's not part of the deal.
It's not part of my orders either, unfortunately. However, you will shave.
All right. Hey, Marines, what do you think about them?
You'll be sorry.
You need any more clues?
Swap jockey. Bunks 19 and 21. All right, listen up. These two men will be joining the 2nd squad for 1 week or less.
For 1 week, exactly.
This is Pruitt. That's Chandler. You've heard of them. They think they're the toughest men in America.
Welcome aboard, Grandpa.
Hey, Lil, have some respect for senior citizens.
Hey, that's a little heavy, isn't it?
Hey, you want some help with that, Grandpa?
Oh, give him some slack. He'll learn soon enough.
Well,
ain't bad. There's something wrong. Look, I keep telling you, everything's gonna be okay. 1 week.
No, it's a setup. Permission from Washington, photographers at the gate, the whole thing. It takes time. These things take planning. What I want to know is who's behind it.
Search me.
Well, it all smells like Moose and Benji to me, and what beats me is what's in it for M&B Trucking.
Okay, the bet, all right?
You got it. Take care, baby.
My bet?
Yeah, you're down. What you got, another six? Dynamite.
You got it.
You see you.
How much we got?
We got $1,500. Another $1,800 called in on the CB. We're going to clean up, baby.
Oh, yeah. We are going to clean up. $10,000 at least.
With all the guys been that Sonny will make it, what happened if they do?
Do what?
Make it. Last week. We're going to have to fail.
What are you, bananas? They got about as much chance of making it as two skunks at a picnic. Now, smart enough, huh? We gotta go collect some money from the truck stop outside of Wilmington.
Good morning, gentlemen.
What time is it?
It's 5:30.
Tell them we're here and we don't want any breakfast.
Do you have exactly 2 minutes to fall in outside for muster? The rules, gentlemen. Remember the rules. You only have 1 week to learn the rules, and that will hardly be enough time for truckers. Let's get with it. Besides, today is going to be an easy day.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
I don't know, Moose. It looks pretty rugged to me. I don't think they're going to make it.
Of course they're going to make it. Don't be crazy, huh?
You said to me that...
Hey, listen, will you shut up? Now, don't listen to him. You listen to me. Now, me and the gunny are like this. He's as good as promised me they're going to get through the whole week.
All right. In that case, I'll take $100.
Hey, now you're using your cup. It's like money in the bank. $100 says they're going to make it through the week.
I don't think I'm going to make it, Will. That's the first intelligent thing you said since you shot your mouth off to that magazine.
You know, yesterday wasn't too bad. But today, this is sheer murder. I got muscles that are hurting. Well, I didn't even know I had muscles.
All you gotta do is limp out of here.
Are you kidding? I'm trying to prove. It's not prove. I just don't want to let the guys down.
Oh.
So just don't let on, huh? I mean, you can complain to me, and I can complain to you, but let's don't let those gyrenes in there hear it, all right?
Grunts. One look at us. You figure that out for themselves.
Where you going?
What does it look like I'm going? I'm gonna try to lie down.
Walk into the barracks like that, and you're all humped over and hobbling, you're walking like an old man. See, those guys feel like an old man, okay, but we gotta make them think that we're enjoying this, that this is the kind of stuff we do every day. If they believe that, they're dumber than we are. And man, we are dumb. Really dumb.
We thought you guys went down the drain.
Congratulations, you made it to another day.
You only got 5 more days left in this lash up. It's a big one on the end.
Just think my taxes are paying for this easy life you got.
Uh-huh. And I want you to know you pay for the college degree I'm going to get. And I appreciate it.
All right, you guys, listen up. You all know what happens tomorrow evening, so I want some volunteers. Gentlemen, gentlemen, where is your spirit of adventure?
Does he want volunteers?
Don't ask, and never volunteer.
That's what Simple Five means.
Okay, I see I've got my 3 volunteers. You, Robinson, and you, Chandler. Report to the field house at 17:30 tomorrow.
What was I volunteered for?
Friday night smoker.
Oh, well, you're probably going to be an usher.
We're in a fight. 3 bouts.
Fights? I'm not mad at anybody.
Gonna pick some guy that you'll learn to be mad at.
How much you want to lay?
I got $100 here.
Let me see it. All right, $100. You got it made, baby.
Got any money on the fight?
No, but I tell you, I was tempted, especially after I saw Brooks working out yesterday.
Yeah, he's got the best right hand in the Corps.
After the Commandant sees those chin whiskers of his, he'll be using that right hand to tear off his stripes.
No sweat, Gunny. He's got the Commandant's permission to grow that fuzz to toughen his skin. Comes off right after the Fleet Championship.
Gloves. How do they feel?
How are they supposed to feel?
What's happened, baby?
Nothing. What are the swabs for?
Oh, that's to patch the cuts.
How did I get into this?
What are you complaining about? Look, it's nothing to go 3 rounds with some muscle-bound Marine. Be a walk-away.
Oh, yada, yada, yada. We're going to clean up.
I don't know, Moose. I've seen Will fight, man. He's not too bad with his fists.
What are you talking about? You see who's fighting? Man, I told the gunny sergeant that Will was a college boxing champ who almost turned pro.
I didn't know that.
And neither does Will.
What'd you tell the gunny sergeant that for?
So he'd match him against Corporal Brooks.
Who's that?
Yeah. That's him over there. He's the champion of the Atlantic Fleet. That's who he is.
Kid, doing great.
Rita.
I'm doing great. Just keep your left up.
Which one is my left?
The one with a watch on it.
Pull it.
Take a deep breath. Let out slow.
Not so. Yeah.
They got him matched with is good enough to turn pro.
I thought Chandler was a college champ.
Where'd you get that idea?
Gunny Harris told me he was intercollegiate champion.
In ping pong, maybe. This is the first time he ever even had the gloves on.
Yeah? Then you can make it to round three. Somebody gave me a snow job. Chandler's never been in the ring before.
Huh?
Yeah. Okay.
Put your hands up. Put up your left. Your left. Put it up. Put it up. Throw your right. Throw your right. Come on. Throw your right.
Looks like we're doing okay to me, Moose.
What are you talking about?
Throw your right. Throw your right.
Look at that dummy. Look at it. Brooks is playing with him.
Well, I don't think so, Will. Looks like he's doing okay.
Come on, Will, baby. Throw left in there. Come on, Will, left.
What are you, stupid? We got our money on the Marine.
Don't call me stupid, Hunky.
Well, don't call me Hunky, stupid.
You're doing great,
huh?
You're doing great.
Something screwy here. All of a sudden, he's giving me advice.
Hey, Moose. What happened with Will last three rounds?
We use our shirts, that's why.
We do?
Matter of fact, you...
think you could have gone the whole three rounds if you hadn't stopped the fight.
Another three rounds, that's all we needed. We'd have had them.
Hey, you sure can't take a punch.
Listen, he hardly laid a glove on us.
Say, if you're in town this time next month, how about a rematch?
Well, we just might consider that.
Sonny?
Yeah.
Next time we get in a fight, I think maybe you should take some of the punches.
Listen up. The fun part of the week is over.
Why didn't you tell me we were having fun?
You got 2 days to get in shape for Tuesday. The mock war. And I mean in shape. I want to see you move. I want to see some snap. I want to see Marines, not a poor imitation of some paunchy truckers. And to make sure I see what I want to see, tomorrow morning, a 3 mile run.
Tucker, Tucker, Tokyo Bell! Tinker Bell was a fairy too!
Tell me something. There's one grunt to another. What do you think?
About what?
About tomorrow, about the big day, the war games. I mean, if there are any rough or any tough...
If I ever say anything about Marines or about being tough, you are free.
Don't worry. I will. Both of them.
This is Moonskins. Traveling west on 44 out of Norfolk. Smokey's on the prowl.
I hope Smokey goes to bed with an empty book.
Roy! Chandler! You guys gonna get through the war exercise?
We'll try.
Trying's not good enough. Not for Marines.
You know what I think about Marines.
Yeah, I read what you think.
Well, my opinion hasn't changed. I still think they're a bunch of muscle-necked hardheads.
Hardheads? For your information, Pruitt, in your battalion, there are 2 5-8s. A Rhodes Scholar candidate, a machine gunner studying for a degree in sociology, and the guy who wrote the prize...
All right, you're both lovable, self-effacing, indispensable, and adorable, okay, okay?
Yeah, well, us truckers are all that.
Maybe. But you're not the toughest man in America.
You know what, Moose? I've been thinking, man. Maybe we just stay partners and whip out that rig between the both of us.
I don't know. I'm getting the feeling that Sonny and Will are going to make it through the week. Unless we do something fast, there's not going to be a new rig. There's not going to be nothing but a whole bunch of trouble, and we got to make that payoff.
I told you, but you wouldn't listen to me. You're too busy calling me stupid. And you want to know something, Moose? You're the one that's stupid. Most of the time, you can't see no farther down the road than the end of that hunky nose of yours.
Just watch it, will you, boy?
Don't boy me.
And look, you're getting me crazy, man. And I don't think so good when I'm crazy.
You don't think too good any time. You know what? Maybe if we paid off some of the Marines to break Sonny and Will's head down that wall. What are you shaking your head for?
I already tried that. There's no takers. We gotta get Sonny and Will to quit because they wanna quit.
Sonny and Will ain't gonna quit, man.
They might. They thought they were being taken.
They're not being taken. Except by us.
You know something?
What?
You just gave me an idea. Come on, let's go make a phone call.
You know what beats me is how Moose found out about this whole setup.
If anybody can spot a con, it's Moose. And Sonny, we have been conned, and well conned. They put us in the hottest platoon in the division. They give us twice as much work as anybody, and then they stick me in the ring with that punching machine, the champion of the Atlantic Fleet. Then they get Gunny Hotshot Harris to ride us into the ground. Pruitt... Super Grunt himself couldn't have made it through this week.
But we almost made it.
Well, I was prepared to give it a try, but I'm not going to fight the whole corps just so they can say that they're tougher than I am. Are you coming?
Yeah, I guess so.
We made it. We won ourselves a bundle.
Yeah, I don't think you should have told him all those lies, Moose.
Yeah, I know, but it made him mad enough to quit, didn't it?
Yeah. I still don't think you should have told all those lies.
I tell you, those truckers are going to be awful mad.
Not when you tell them the facts.
Makes you wonder. The United States Marines. Who would have believed that they would pull a dirty stunt like that? They didn't even need to. Because I don't think I could have made it through that war tomorrow anyway. They could have won it honest.
You knuckleheads. Have you got Liberty passes?
Yeah, we got passes. Permanent ones.
You're quitting?
Well, let's just say we don't like working against the stacked odds.
Nothing stacked.
The men in your squad told me about your phone call. I'll tell you something. So far, you've pretty well managed to handle yourselves like Marines. Not first-class Marines, but Marines. Another few days, and I'd have had you in shape for anything.
Starting to worry about your 50.
I will say this one time. You two have received no special treatment. You were assigned to an ordinary platoon on routine training. You have done for 6 days what every other Marine does 365 days a year. Nobody has pushed you harder than any other man in the Corps, from the Commandant on down. You see, being a Marine is believing. Believing you can do what you're required to do. Believing you're the toughest. Believing you're the best. If you believe it strongly enough, the rest is easy.
I believe, man. I believe.
All right. Get on back to base on the double. I forget I saw you. Oh, one more thing. You still haven't made it through your week. Tomorrow's war. It's where we separate the truckers from the Marines. Close it up. We're going into the combat area. If you guys want to stay in one piece, remember the safety regulations. It's okay, move out! Go! Come on, gentlemen, let's move out!
Squad, that'll give you a soft.
That's right, Skipper.
First squad, first platoon on the double!
Okay, Jess, bring it in a little bit.
We
We've got no change to our situation. You know, directly to our north, we've got about 800 meters to the front.
Take cover behind that knoll. Get online.
I think we have to go.
Yeah, I can cover you up and come back for you later.
Outstanding.
You okay, Pruitt?
Oh, I'm just getting a little pooped.
That's impossible. You're one of the toughest men in America. Hop in, Adam. Come on, move your butt.
All right.
Another 4 hours to go.
6 hours. Ready to quit, or are you starting to believe?
I'm starting to believe. Is that ammo truck supposed to be part of this charade?
Some stupid truck driver. You stay put. I gotta get that thing out of here. You stay put!
He's on fire. I'll get the gunny. Get the truck.
To receive citations in all colors. Center. Forward. Halt. Detachment. Halt.
Citation. Mr. Will Chandler. While accompanying Company B, 1st Battalion, 8th Marines, 2nd Marine Division, FMF, in a training exercise, distinguished himself when, at the risk of his own life, he performed a courageous and selfless act. Citation. Mr. Sonny Pruitt, while accompanying Company B, 1st Battalion, 8th Marines, 2nd Marine Division FMF, in a training exercise, risk his life to save the life of a comrade.
Congratulations to you. Very fine. Congratulations to you.
Well, gentlemen, from the very beginning, when I requested permission of the commandant to invite you aboard, I believe that only good could come from having you with us. Those of us in the Marine Corps and our comrades in the Army, Navy, and Air Force have something to learn from men like you, and I trust you've learned something from us. I hope that we've earned your respect. You've certainly earned ours, for you've proven that the values we hold dear are the same values that you live by. These awards are a reminder of our common bond.
Like a trucker's convention.
Well, Moose and Benji took a lot of money that we wouldn't make it.
Right.
They're gonna have to pay off all those guys.
Right again.
Of course, we do have the $500 left from the money that the gyrenes gave us.
We have the fun. We would be knuckleheads to give them a dime.
Well, you're right. We would be knuckleheads.
Of course, it would help Moose and Benji out of a big hole.
Okay. Okay. Dean! That's my good little knucklehead.
Give that to Moose and Benji. Tell them they owe me $5.
Right.